Now, the last thing that I would like to pass on to you is the statement that's very important. It's the last guideline in the seventh. Pass it on to others. And I'd like to pass this on to you, by the way. Not only read the Bible, not only study the Bible, not only meditate on the Bible, and not only read what others have written about it, and not only obey it, but pass it on to others. And frankly, if we obey it, that's what we'll be doing. That's what we all should do. Now, you're going to reach a saturation point in the study of the Bible unless you pass it on to others. That's something that you need to recognize. You know, God, for some reason, won't let you withdraw yourself from mankind in a monastery and become some sort of a walking Bible encyclopedia, knowing everything, and the rest of us remain ignorant. I think that's the reason that he made the statement that we are not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, as the manner of some is, but exhorting one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. Don't forget to assemble yourself with others. And that's one of the reasons I think that God has blessed this program as he has, is because of the fact that we're tempting to pass it on to others. A preacher wrote me, and he said, Dr. McGee, I'm using your program. Do you mind if I use your outlines and your notes? Of course I don't mind. You can have anything this poor preacher's written, and if it would prove helpful to you, why, we'd certainly want you to have it. But that's exactly what we want to do, is to pass it on to others. Because I find that when we pass it on to others, that it becomes a blessing. Now, I learned this lesson early in seminary. I pastored a little church. And there were about five other fellows in my class that did the same thing. They had a little church. And for 2 years, I had that little church before I graduated. And we five fellows, or six of us as the total was, we used to get together and talk things over. Because as young pastors, just seminary students, not even dry back of the ears, and we were very green concerning many things, why, we'd get together and talk over our mutual problems, our mutual situations, and what we could do. And in the course of the 2 years, we made a discovery that we were taking what we were learning in class, that which was given to us, and we were passing it on to others, that which we'd learned. And may I say this to you? That we found out that when we graduated, we actually were a year ahead of the other members of the class. Why? Because we were smarter than the others? No. May I say we were not. I happened to be in a class in which there were several very bright young men, and we were not brighter than they were. We had just had the experience of passing it on to others, and when we did, God was able to funnel in to us a great deal more than he might otherwise. This is important. And we have also rejoiced in the fact, I've shared letters with you from time to time, and as we've said, these letters are always typical. And these letters tell of folk who began listening to the program, got interested, opened up their home, and they're now conducting a Bible class. There are others that open their home and they just use our tapes, and they use the tapes of others. And many of them have pastors that come in. Many pastors have started classes, and all of them testify to the fact that it has increased their knowledge of the Word of God. That's what God wants us to do. Pass it on. Don't forget, begin with prayer. Read the Bible. Study the Bible. Meditate upon the Bible, read what others have written on the Bible, and pass the Bible on to others. And in our guidelines that we're mailing out, I don't even mention it this time, I have a hand there in which you can learn the books of the Bible and put them on one hand. The chart is there. Be sure and write in for your copy today.